Hi folks and Happy New Year! This is the first video we are doing in 2020 and we are starting off easy. This is another pour that I'm going to do before everything is arranged and set up for Patrick to begin. So let's start easy today. I did mix a couple of paints yesterday, about 10 liters or so for Patrick to give it a good start. And I came up with a color palette that I encountered during the mixing. I intended to start off with my regular one, so like the blue tones, my signature colors, but I want to see if this works out. So this is a rose metallic. This is cream, gold, white, and copper. Copper metallic, to be exact. I actually thought that a red might be better, except for the cover, but let's keep it a bit more muted. Not sure if this is going to work out, but I'm curious to see what happens. And let's just layer up the paints for now. I want those to come out last, this is why I put them in first. Bit of white, followed by cream. So I want the brighter colors to be a bit more towards the center, that I can stretch them. And all the other colors to be more like on the outside, that they might run off the canvas anyways. So I'm not sure, I've never tried this color palette before. But the colors together might look nice, I think. And while I'm putting the paints in here, I can talk about some stuff that is going to come. So, as I announced in my last video for the New Year's Eve Sylvester, I'm going to go more for the realism this year. And therefore you're going to see more painting, drawing and realism works, some tutorials on how I paint things. And as this channel is basically based around you and learning channel, I am always happy to hear what you would like to see. So if there are some topics you are struggling with, like portraiture or landscape painting or such, then leave me in the comments and I will be happy to do the best what I can to help out. I'm not that much of a landscape painter myself, but I think we'll find a way to figure out to help as much as we can. And therefore in the comment section you can all leave your comments and ideas and tips and tricks, so that we can improve everyone step by step. So I think this is enough paint in my cup here. I still have a couple of paints left. I will just use those as a base layer coat and mix them together. This would help the paint to flow easier, so this is going to be a pretty ugly mix, I think. So some rose first. And there's some of the white left. The other colors are pretty empty already, so I'm just using those and spread them around. No, not that ugly at all. It's pretty nice though. Even this white would be a cool background for something rose. Rose flower arrangements topic, perhaps. So, we can do this in the future. So if you are into landscape and flower paintings, perhaps, let me know as well. And we'll make some more flower paintings. I did a couple in the past already, so you might have seen those. Like this one here, for example. So this is something I did in last year as well. So if you want to see something like this, a bit more often, let me know as well. And this one is still available on my Etsy if you like. So let's give this. So this cup already looks pretty cool. So I hope you can see it. some air bubbles here, so this is just a quick torch to get them away. So there's no silicone in, I don't want to have cells at all. And let's see what we can get. It is pretty much paint, so I ran a bit overboard, I guess. But I want to keep as much of the outside cream here. So I'm going to tilt a bit more towards this direction to get some of the paint over the border already. It really did sell up here a lot, although there is no silicone. I'm pretty sure this is based from the metallic rose and copper. I don't really like this little spot here. Let's see if I can cover it up with some pure copper, so that is not that obvious anymore. And I'm really curious to see how this one dries. I hope these cells do not get overboard. So if it stays like this, it's okay, but I hope not the entire area is going to sell up. Everything is going to dry a bit darker, so the copper is going to be more on the contrast side again, and the gold, you know what the gold looks like. I cannot wait to see how this one dries. And this is pretty much cool enough to not end up being a background. We will see. So thank you for joining for the first video of this year. I will give you a quick overview of the picture painting in a close-up, and I will show you the right result in the next video, because I want to upload this one here just to not let you waiting too long. Can you see the shimmer? It's really cool. In real life, the colors look a bit different than here on the screen that I can see now. I'm not sure if it looks on the computer then, but yeah, usually in the dried version you will see the exact colors. Really like how it looks so far. That was fun. So, thanks for joining for this video, and see you very, very soon. Bye-bye.